a somewhat depressing year for equities, especially in the fourth quarter. The first three quarters of the year were all right, with a return in MSCI World in euro terms of about 10%. But this all was gone after the end of the fourth quarter, where MSCI World had given a total return in 2018 of about -4%. At the same time, depicted here is the German 10-year government bond rate, which has been fluctuating but having a downward tendency and actually ended the year about 0.25%. So this is showing that there's a lot of pessimism in markets currently, and this is also captured in the slope of the U.S. yield curve, which is the difference between the 2- and 10-year government bond rates. As you can see here, it began with a somewhat of a steepening in January, where equity markets also performed quite well, and then it has basically been downtrending ever since, basically also all the way through Christmas, and then increasing just slightly in the very last days of the year, but still being suspiciously close to zero, which is the very dangerous territory, after which, if that happens, one can expect a recession with a delay of 6, 9, or 12 months or something like that. So this is definitely a cause for concern. Also, looking at the US monetary policy, throughout the year, the Fed funds rate was hiked several times here of 25 basis points, lately in December, where it was hiked to 2.5%. That happened at a time where five-year inflation swaps were dropping quite heavily by about 35 basis points in the matter of the course of 2 or 3 months, which is quite a heavy drop. So in that regard, it's not really a typical thing to be hiking interest rates when long-term inflation expectations are dropping that fast and that heavily. Also depicted here is sorry, that's not the Eurozone, that's the futures market expectation for the Fed funds rate in December 2020, so roughly 2 years ahead. So it is a cause for concern that the futures market is saying that basically over the next 2 years, these two rate hikes will have to be unwound or scaled back. So they basically expect the Fed funds rate to be about 2% in December 2020. So there's a lot of pessimism in the stir futures market, especially for the U.S. monetary policy. Another reason or way we can explain the nervousness and the negative market reactions we've seen lately in especially Europe, where equity markets were dropping 10% throughout the year, it was not as bad in the U.S., definitely not as bad, is that the over-optimism has been definitely a lot worse in Europe than in the U.S. So what I've gathered here is two indicators. It's the soft indicators and the hard indicators, both normalized around zero, and this in terms of standard deviation, so these are basically C scores. So whenever this is very high here, of about 1.5 C scores, that's a sign of over-optimism. And especially if you look at the spread between the hard data and the soft data, when that is very positive or very high, that's a way of calculating or measuring over-optimism that happened just at the height of the IT bubble and just ahead of the big financial crisis. And it also happened just ahead of the euro crisis here. And then that is quickly turning into become an over-pessimism. But sadly, currently we have an over-optimism, which was especially pronounced as we went into 2018. And this spread was quite wide, so meaning that the soft data was a lot higher than the hard data. And even though the soft data has been receding somewhat throughout the year, the hard data has also been deteriorating. So basically, the spread has been more or less unchanged throughout the year. And that means that the over-optimism is still there, and it really needs to come down before equities are really interesting in the in the Eurozone in the very short term. Another thing that is kind of corroborating this this message is that the leading indicators are continuing to drop, and that especially goes for the Eurozone here, which has been dropping continuously for the past 11 months. It's also dropping in the US, the yellow one here, and the green one is in Japan, where the latest point is actually slightly up, but I suspect that will be revised lower as we get the final quarterly data out of Japan in a couple of months. So when leading indicators are dropping, that just tells you that the growth outlook is also dropping, and we haven't seen a bottom yet, so we basically can expect that 6 to 9 months from here, the growth outlook is still continuing to become lower and lower, and that is definitely not a nice area to or economic environment to be investing in risky asset classes. A third thing that is actually telling me that you should have a very cautious approach to investing in the months ahead is our monthly momentum and volatility indicators. And I can see there's a lot of colors here, but basically the fat black line here is the one for the developed world, which is basically capturing all of the information we have in the other indicators and basically comprising about 200 different indicators all on stock market performance. And last month, at the end of November, it was just ahead of the threshold of 0.6, above which we would like to have equities, and now it has dropped throughout December quite heavily to about 0.3, which is way below the threshold, and therefore I basically don't have any arguments for why you should be long equities any longer. Unfortunately, my message is that one should have an underweight to risk, an underweight to equities compared to the long-term target allocation one would have.